People. devastating for the family, which has already had to endure so much. From the new information obtained from Belfield, who now calls himself Yusuf Rahim, about a possible accomplice. Surrey police arrested a man in his 40s. He was then released without charge, as the police said there was no evidence to support the claim. Trials. You have reduced these families to an unimagined grief. Mrs. Justice Rafferty, BBC News Online, February 2008, said. Trial in connection with the murder of Amelia Delagrange. Evie Belfield's trial begins at the Old Bailey, London, on Friday the 12th of October 2007 for the murders of Marsha McDonnell and Amelia Delagrange, the attempted murder of Irma Dragoshi and Kate Sheedy, and the attempted kidnap of Anna Marie. It denies all accounts. Brian Altman, prosecuting, states that these women were targeted victims of a predatory man who stalked bus stops and bus routes in vehicles looking for young women to attack. He calls on witness Cyril Garo, who was an associate of Belfield. He had been in the car with Belfield when he announced, "Watch this," and then proceeded to attack Irma Dragoshi. Despite this testimony, Belfield tries instead to frame Garo for the attack. The jury discovered that 6 days after the murder of Amelia Delagrange, Belfield breaks down in his bedroom, having taken an overdose of antidepressants. He's found by a friend, and it's here that Belfield announces, "You don't know what I have done." He's admitted to the mental hospital, where he tells staff he's feeling low and suicidal. However, he discharges himself the next day. During the trial, Belfield repeatedly denies being present at the attacks. He claims his work as a wheel clamper gives him access to a variety of cars that other people within his team can also use. Brian Altman suggests to the jury that Belfield is messaging evidence and providing fictitious accounts. Belfield appeals to the jury that he is the victim of mistaken identity. Despite this, on the 25th of February 2008, the jury find him guilty of the murders of Amelia Delagrange and Marsha McDonnell, and the attempted murder of Kate Sheedy. Belfield shows his true cowardly colours when he chooses not to attend his sentencing. Bad publicity overnight is blamed for his non-appearance. He's sentenced by Mrs. Justice Rafferty to a whole life term. Trial in connection with the murder of Millie Dowler. On the 10th of May 2011, the trial begins of the murder of Millie Dowler and the attempted abduction of Rachel Cowles at the Old Bailey. It emerges at the trial that Belfield's family went to home on the day of Millie's disappearance, and Emma Mills remembers that she was unable to get a hold of Belfield on his mobile phone, which was highly unusual. She also recalls how he was wearing different clothes to the ones he had on in the morning, despite something that he was saying that he was spending the night at the Colin Wood address. When Mills went there the next day, the bed has no sheets, duvet or pillowcases on. Belfield tells her that the dog had fouled on them, on the bedding, so he disposed of it, and Emma knows this is something he would never do. He then mentions that he wants her to move back to West Drayton. She agrees, and the next day, in great haste, he moves his family out of the Collingwood address one day after the disappearance of Millie Dowler. In a cruel twist, Belfield tells Mr. Justice Wilkie that he will not be given evidence in his defence. It's his attempt to put Bob and Sally Dowler on trial. Belfield's defence team drag up the dirt they can find involving Bob Dowler, and they reveal that he was even a suspect at one point. The police need to talk to the owner, but they have 26,000 funds to eliminate first. Even help from the DVLA can't help them, and the trial for the killer goes cold. A woman coming in saying that her ex-boyfriend Levi Belfield is a potential suspect. His name is added to the 129 names on the ex-girlfriend's list. Detectives decide to cross-reference this list to see if any owner white van Belfield's name fits a brief. Armed with this information, it doesn't take long.
Certainly seems a nice woman, she seems.